These are just some of the jobs that I've had in my life. And why did I decide to leave those jobs and become my own boss? Because those jobs sucked. That's why I wanted to help you out and give you some home-based business ideas that don't suck. Because the last thing you want is to start your own business and your business sucks. Now you're the owner of a sucky company. Nah, that's not gonna work here. So I know a lot of you have no patience at all. So we're gonna get right into this one. So the first home-based business idea that does not suck is affiliate marketing. Yes, you can make an entire business from affiliate marketing. So if you're not familiar with affiliate marketing, it's when you suggest a product or service to people, and when people either click on the URL or if they buy something from that company, depending on what the agreement is, then you can earn some money for referring people to that business. But one word of advice. So if you're going to do affiliate marketing, just make sure it's a company or product that you actually like or that you actually believe in. Because if you send people over to a sucky product or service, they are going to remember that and they are not going to trust you in the future. So just make sure that when you are posting affiliate links, that these are things that you actually like. But I know you're wondering, like, okay, well, how do I get into affiliate marketing? No worries, I got you. So on my website, nikkiconnected.com, I did an entire blog post of the best affiliate marketing companies that you can join as a beginner. So these are all companies where you can earn a lot of money. And I'm talking about $75, $100, over $200 for referring people to purchase a product. So yeah, after you watch this video, make sure you check out that blog post if you want to get into affiliate marketing. I have all the gems in that post. Affiliate marketing definitely does not suck, especially since you can make your own hours and you can choose when and how you refer people to those products. The next home-based business idea that doesn't suck is selling physical products. Yeah, I know it may seem obvious, but you need to think about what kind of products you would actually want to sell from your home. One thing that I used to do is I would sell custom vinyl decals on Etsy. So what vinyl decals are is they're like basically stickers that you can put on your walls or on products, and they are removable as well. So what I did was I would create people's names or designs and they could personalize their products, because I have a Cricut machine, and I don't know if you know what a Cricut machine is, but that thing is like magical. You can make so many different crafts, and I'm not even the craft type. So people would give me names and I would put those in my Cricut design space and print them out and have them ready to ship in minutes with my Cricut machine. So word of advice, if you are gonna start a home-based business that requires physical products, you might wanna consider getting yourself a Cricut machine. I'll link it down below. But that's just one idea for you. I know a lot of people that sell beauty products from home. So you can actually make the beauty products from your home. You can buy containers in bulk. There you go, you have a business. And another idea to keep the wheels turning is to start a t-shirt business from home. T-shirts aren't going anywhere. Everybody wears them, right? So you can customize t-shirts and send them to people. And if you have a Cricut machine, it makes it a lot easier. But do you know the best kept secret to taking your selling business to the next level? The packaging. Have you ever ordered something and the packaging looks like it was thrown together by a first grader? I have. Not a good look for the business. If the packaging is ratchet, say bye-bye to repeat sales. That's where today's sponsor, No Issue, can help. They help give your customer a good unboxing experience, and it's good for the planet. Let me show you. I love their stuff. Imagine you get a package in the mail, you open your box, and the packing paper is designed like a newspaper that you can read and even do a crossword puzzle. What are you likely going to do with that? Put it on Instagram. You see where I'm going with this? It's free promo for your business when people are putting it on social media. The newspaper wrapper is just one of the many options you can create with No Issue. They also have outer packaging like this mailer. I wish you could feel this. It's sensational. And the packaging is recycled, compostable, or reusable. So you're helping the planet and you're helping your sales. Because when you create a great unboxing experience, it increases your repeat sales by 52%. Yes. And it shows your customers that you're a responsible business owner, because people really do care about how your business helps the planet. And unlike many other companies that sell packaging, No Issue sells to businesses of all sizes. So even if you're just starting out, you can use No Issue and give your business that professional look that it needs to keep customers coming back. To see it for yourself and start designing your packaging today, head on over to No Issue's website. It's in the description box below this video. It's time to step up our game, ladies and gentlemen. And a word of advice, if you're gonna sell products, make sure you get yourself out there, let people know that you exist, and have a professional ordering experience as well for your customers. Now, you can do a link in bio on Instagram, or you can get yourself a website. And one platform that I suggest is Bluehost if you are going to start a website, because their platforms start at $2.95 a month for a whole website. But I'm going to talk a little bit more about that later. And if you are going to sell on Etsy, just make sure that you're using your SEO skills, your search engine optimization, and basically you're using keywords throughout your item description. The more words, the better, so people can find you easier. I do suggest that you make life a lot easier and use Sales Samurai. That's a platform that I use for my Etsy store where it works in the background, and basically I can spy on my competition, find out what keywords they're using, use those keywords, add better keywords. It does all the research for me, and it just makes my life so much easier. So if you're interested in Sales Samurai, I'll link it down below as well. But we have to move on to more home-based business ideas that don't suck. Let's go. So in case you don't want to sell physical products, it just may not be your cup of tea. No worries, you can sell digital products. I have a bunch of ways that I sell digital products, and I've talked about a lot of them on this channel. One thing that I like to do is sell low content books. Those are like journals and calendars, planners, things where the customer would fill out the interior of those books. What I do is I create a book cover on Canva. I will link them down below. You can use them for free. And then I'll do keyword research and use a lister on a platform called BookBalt. They make it so much easier to list those low content books on Amazon KDP, and it's like that. I have low content books. And you can also check out my book vault video. It's this one. I'll link that down below as well. But some other digital products that I sell are YouTube thumbnails, YouTube banners. Do you get where I'm going here? I'm selling things that I'm used to. So I have a YouTube channel. I create my own banners and thumbnails. So why not create them for other people and make money on top of that? So there are plenty of people that make a full-time income by selling digital products. And if you're wondering what platforms are good to sell digital products, Amazon KDP, if you're interested in the low content books. Another platform that I like to use is Etsy, because Etsy is really cheap to list on there. And Fiverr is another great place to sell digital products. And the next idea is blogging. Yes, blogging is a business. There are plenty of people that make a full-time income from blogging, and blogging is yet again something that I do. As a matter of fact, this is my blog right here, Nikki Connected. So it's nikkiconnected.com. I have been blogging since 2015, and I actually blogged before I started my YouTube channel. And the thing about blogging that a lot of people don't realize is there are a bunch of ways that you can make money. And no, this job does not suck. And to me, one of the main reasons why blogging does not suck is because you have so many opportunities that open up for you when you have a successful blog. I've been invited to awesome events with huge companies and been given the VIP treatment like no other from my blog, not my YouTube channel. For some reason, I feel like you get more respect as a blogger than you do as a YouTube creator, but it could just be me. But I get way more for my blog than I do on YouTube. But when it comes to blogging, there are multiple ways where you can make money. And the main way is to get ads put on your website. So if you're starting out, you might want to look into Google AdSense. But once you get more traction on your blog and you start to grow and get more visitors and page views, then you can start going to ad networks. Now, the ad networks is where it's at. The ad network that I'm a part of is She Media. So She Media pays me to put ads on my website, and they pay way more than Google AdSense ever did. And not only that, but they also helped me with business opportunities, with business growth. I've done a whole bunch of events with them. Like, I'm telling you, they make you feel like a queen over there. But there are other ad networks out there, including Mediavine. I don't know much about them. I have never joined them, so I'm not gonna go too deep into it. But that's one of the popular ones as well. So opportunities can open up at every level. But another way that you can earn with blogging, the biggest moneymaker on my blog is affiliate marketing. When you're doing your blog posts, make sure you're putting affiliate links in there to send people over to products and services that you highly believe in, not just throwing some willy-nilly stuff up there. But if you're wondering how do you get started with blogging, then you definitely want to start with a web host. The host is basically the land that your blog is going to sit on. Just like when you buy a house, you need to pay for some land for that house to sit on. So the host that I recommend is Bluehost. I mentioned it a little earlier in this video. You can start a blog for as little as $2.95 a month with Bluehost. I'm going to link them down below so that you can sign up and see what they are all about. But enough about blogging. Let's get into the next home-based business idea that does not suck. Now, another home-based business idea that does not suck is starting a YouTube channel. That's right. There are plenty of people that have a home-based business around a YouTube channel. So you can use your YouTube channel a variety of ways. For me, my blog came first. So I used my YouTube channel to bring more people over to my blog. Eventually, YouTube became the primary platform for me, and now the blog is secondary. But if you have a t-shirt business, you can go ahead and create a YouTube channel and let people know about your product. You can create short videos of you creating your product or designing your product or packaging your product and put that on YouTube Shorts because people are interested in that kind of stuff. But I know what you're thinking. You're like,
okay, but if I start a YouTube channel, I'm not gonna make money right away.
Yeah, you're kinda right. But there are other ways to make money on YouTube other than the YouTube ad revenue. As we all know, you need 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 watch hours in the last 12 months in order to get monetized on YouTube, and then you'll start getting paid that ad revenue through Google AdSense. But if you're not there yet, no worries. Still, put videos out. That's the first thing. You have to create videos because, first of all, if you look at like any creator's videos, all of our early videos are stinkers. You got to get that out of your system. So get those videos out, get used to recording. And if you're worried about the whole equipment thing, don't worry about it because you can build up as you go along, just like I did. But if you are interested in cheap equipment to start a YouTube channel, I actually have a blog post on that. So I'll make sure I link that down below as well so you can check it out. But also, the biggest money makers for a lot of YouTube creators are the affiliate links below our videos. So that's why I encourage people to click my links instead of going directly to the websites, because it benefits me and it helps keep this channel going so that I can keep bringing you great content. We here, right? You understand. But yeah, affiliate links can make you quite a bit of money on your YouTube channel even without being monetized. And then when you build up and do get more subscribers and get monetized, then you'll start seeing the bigger things come in, such as the brand deals and, you know, just the good stuff. But I want to hear from you. Let me know in the comments, is there a home-based business idea that you have that you've been wanting to start? And if you do have a YouTube channel, please let me know in the comments, and basically you're letting the world know. So I know a lot of creators don't want people to do that, putting their YouTube channels in the comments. I encourage it here. So please do, if you have a YouTube channel, let me know in the comments so that I can check out your channel. I am subscribed to a lot of people that are subscribed to me, and I don't announce it or anything. People get shocked, like, oh my gosh, like, you subscribe? Yeah, like, if I like your channel, I'm going to subscribe. So please let me and the whole family know about your YouTube channel or podcast or other business idea that you have, or business that you are actually running. Then let us know in the comments. On that note, If you do like this video, then please let me and the algorithm know by hitting thumbs up. And also, please don't forget to subscribe and turn on your notifications so you can be notified when I drop a new video. And there's a new little feature down there that if you want to really thank me and support a single mom, then hit that thanks button. I would appreciate it. And real quick, I want to thank No Issue for sponsoring this video. They are awesome. So if you are selling physical products, I highly suggest that you get their packaging to send your products to your customers. Your customers are going to love you for it. But with that said, if you're interested in more money-making ideas, then I suggest you watch this video. I'll see you in the next one. Bye, y'all.
I might be broken down, but I'm smiling. I keep my head up high, though I fail. Sometimes I get a bit emotional, but then I turn around and